What is up, guys? My name is Andrew, and welcome back to Space Engineers. This is episode number 11. And last episode, we built this really nice elevator. Unfortunately, it has a little bit of a problem with this side right here. Every time we do anything to the base, or even just jump on it, or even move, it bangs against this thing right here. And it causes lots of problems, like destruction of elevator and stuff like that. So you guys actually had a really good suggestion that you guys left. You said that we can actually use... what are they called? Blast door pieces, and those will go here nicely. And they won't actually clang against anything, because apparently they have a smaller hitbox. So we're going to try that out. So let's destroy... I guess we'll destroy everything on the outside, including our button panel, unfortunately. We'll have to go and reset some buttons. But all these outside pieces, get those out of here. Oop, that one as well. Okay, so you're not clanging, right? Okay, so that's fine. We're going to keep that one right there because that's the one we're going to stick our button panel on most likely. And then on the outside, we can use blast door, which I've never used before, so this will be interesting. Blast door pieces, let's throw it in right here where the solar panels are, and we'll place it like... How does it go? Is there like a particular way? We have edges. So that's a corner. That's a normal one, and then these ones are edges. Probably, we could use edges. That would look pretty nice. Edge right here, we'll put an edge right here. We'll put one on each side, and then we'll have a corner matching them up, and that'll probably look really cool. Really interior designy and awesome. Okay, so the corner, there was one, right? Yeah, okay, so the corner we could stick right there. Ooh, look at that. I mean, you can't really see much, but it's gonna look nice, and I can already tell. It's probably gonna look much nicer of an elevator than it did before. What do you guys require? Just steel plates. Oh, a lot of them though. Good lord. Okay, well, let's go grab a bunch of steel plates. And last episode, we built this super nice and fancy looking cargo area, which has yet to be pressurized, but it's built, which is good. Grab a bunch of these. We're going to need at least, 900 probably sounds good. We have what? How many are these there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we're going to need more than 900 probably. But we'll see. And I'll paint these a color so they don't look like this. Oop, 900 was fine. How many do we have left? 6. Wow. Okay. Well, that works. Now this right here, the reason I'm keeping it a normal block is because I don't think you can place things like button panels on top of... Wait, you can. Okay. Well, part... Can I... I'm actually not sure if you can. Like, that might be linking up with this. Oh, because there's a piece on it. Oh, actually, I can place it like that then if I want. No. Okay, we're just going to place it like this. We're going to remove that, and we're going to stick the button panel on top right here. All right, there we go. There's our elevator. It looks weird with that middle piece right there, and I wish we could do something about that and still have our button, but the only other alternative would be to have our button, like, on the side, and I do want to be able to control the elevator mid-flight, or mid-elevation, I guess. However, with this design, we can probably throw these back on here. Energy is low. Okay, well, let's go and grab some energy then. I don't think we repressurized this room ever, so... Yeah, it's probably for the best for now. But yeah, we can re-put those there, and once we get some steel plates, and we're probably going to need more, because we're running out a little bit. So we'll go to production, tell you to make us 4,000 of those. How much iron do we have, is a good question. FE. Let's see, it looks like we have... Oh, we actually have a lot of iron, because I think we still have some that's refining. No, it just refined, so we have quite a bit. We have enough to make at least 4,000 steel plates. You are bothering me, but I think we're going to... Yeah, we're going to stick stuff there, so you're not really bothering me that much. You guys... Fix you guys up. Different paint job from here to here. That kind of bothers me. So does this little speck right here. What the heck? It got bigger. We made it bigger. We grew it. But yeah, let's do this maiden voyage. The maiden voyage of the new elevator. And here we go. Look at this. Do you hear anything? Other than my voice? No, because it's not rubbing against that. That's awesome. This is a smooth ride. We had a thing to stop it, didn't we? We don't have that anymore. Oh, shoot. It's going to hit the top. Oh, we got to go. Ow. What was that? I don't know what that was. Group. Toggle block on and off. So that's the power. What happened here? Why did I just take a lot of damage randomly? I'm kind of confused. Let's go back down. So I can go and reheal myself. I don't know. What happened there? Did you guys see? It was like I like bumped up against the side or something. I might have hit that. I don't know. Whatever it was. It was crazy. All right. How does she look? Look at this. This looks awesome. I've got the lights in it and everything. I'm not even using my flashlight. That's with the flashlight, which I want to stop using the flashlight a little bit because I feel like it makes it so that I don't have to build lights, which is kind of annoying. I want to put lights in all the rooms, make them look a little bit nicer, especially like this, just because I think the game's lights make the game look so much better than just running around using the flashlight everywhere. But yeah, what do you think? I'm gonna see how she works. I like how it gets darker when you go up, and if I want to go down, let's see. Yeah, there we go. Once you get down, well, I mean, it's a little bit weird with this bouncy, but I mean, you can only expect that after using like 18 pistons in a row, so that's fair. So I think the elevator is almost done, but there's one other thing we need to fix to make it look a little bit nicer. We need to fix that. That just looks scary, and it shouldn't look scary. It should look nice and welcoming and stuff. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try and hollow out most of this. We're gonna make it a much larger entrance, is what I'll say. We'll make it a much larger entrance, and we'll try to, maybe we'll even move the ladder so that it's a little bit farther back. I'm not sure how we're going to do that quite yet, but I want to make it look a little bit more welcoming. We'll have lights, we'll have probably glass. It's going to look super awesome. So let's start with, we'll use the mini miner to start start drilling out actually, you know what? Ooh, here's one thing that some of you guys were suggesting earlier. What if, now hear me out now, what if we bring this up a little bit, then turn it off, just so it's floating there for a second. If we can manage to stick a drill on this thing, we could actually have it go up there and automatically drill for us. So you know what? Yeah, let's try that. I think that's a really good idea. Okay, bring it back down, actually. I wanted to see if we could stick it on the underside. Oops, it's turned off. I wanted to see if we could stick the drills on the underside since we already have these blocks here, but instead, I think we're just gonna do this. We're just gonna weld out all the corner ones right here. And we're going to stick normal blocks on those for the time being. We'll eventually put them back to look nice, but this is just for the utility part. Oh no, there goes some stuff. Whatever, we'll go down and grab that in a bit. Oh shoot, but if I stick these... Okay, hang on. Instead of that, then let's do this. We'll do a half block. There we go. We're sticking half blocks because I think we can still stick a drill on top of a half block. The only difference is that it won't like clang against the side because it's only a half block. So yeah. Okay. Looks like we're working from the underside. And let's go and grab those steel plates that fell down. I don't want to lose them all. How many of them could have been down here? Let's turn our light back on. Hey, there were computers. I thought there were steel plates. Huh. Is there anything else down here? Oh, okay. I should really make that look more like a shaft, I guess, but I don't know. Okay, so we want some drills on there. Drill, grab that, and we're gonna stick it like right here. I don't know how well this is gonna work just because of this thing. Okay, there we go. Okay, so now if I sit in this seat, I should be able to go up there while right-click mining, and that should make this hole a little bit larger. Not really on this side because we don't have the one there because the ladder's there, but yeah, it should make it a little bit larger. Okay, let's hop in here. Reverse. All right, and we'll start mining. Ooh, look at that, it's working. It's not getting that much bigger, but at least it should make it like a nice perfect circle or somewhat that because we have the stairs on the other side. But yeah, this is working pretty well. I wonder what's gonna happen once we get closer to like the actual top. Probably bad things. Expect very bad things to happen. Right here. No, that wasn't that bad, actually. And maybe we'll grab a little bit of this. Okay, there we go. That was actually very smooth! I'm impressed! And let's see, what did we... Is it, like, perfect? Well, it's not perfect, but, like, it's good. It's decent. Okay, you know what? I've got a cutting plan, but it's going to involve destroying the ladder, so we're gonna... Yeah, it's time. I'm sorry, ladder. But you're getting destroyed for now. You might be added back later. Here's the elevator excavator Mark II. Let's go. We've got the same situation here. We're gonna hop in here and we're gonna say reverse on our elevator, and that's when we'll be good to go. Go! So this one might go a little bit slower, I imagine, because we're gonna be running into the wall. Or I guess it'd be the ceiling in this case. Actually, I say that and it's going really well, really smoothly. This is pretty good. I think we'll go one more after this, just to make it like a nice large entrance size. Now we might have to go and destroy some of that right there. I don't know, we'll see. No, actually it goes right by it. That was really cool. Okay, we'll stop right here. We don't want to make it any much larger on this front. Okay, and go back down so we can go and edit it. How does it look now? Okay, it's much larger than it originally was, which is really nice. And like I said, I think one more will be perfect. Alrighty, here's tier 3 of the elevator excavator, and it's doing the same thing, just a little bit larger. So yeah, let's get to it. We're gonna hop into our seat once again, like normal. And we're totally gonna run into something, because there was something that we almost ran into last time. We're gonna run into it at some point this time. But let's do it. Okay. Elevator. Reverse. And let's go. Oops, I'm left-click mining there. We gotta be right-click mining, otherwise we're gonna have a lot of rock meeting us when we get back down. This is really efficient. This is probably way faster than it would be, and way nicer, might I add, than if I had used the mini miner to try and excavate all of this. So that's the thing we're gonna run into right there. We could just mine right through it. That wouldn't hurt anyone, right? Well, that'd probably take forever. Okay, hang on. Oh my god! Oh my god, it's moving at all! Oops. Sorry, random pieces of stuff. I kind of broke that a little bit. I think that's actually fine. So it kind of comes back up once it gets there. So it kind of comes back into like an area. That's looking pretty nice. So what we're going to do now is we're going to actually make it a nice elevator shaft. So you won't see any rock as you're going down. You'll only see elevator shaft. And then you'll see the rock once you're down here. So the whole time you're going down, you won't really know where you're going. And this is going to get redone as well. I'm still sad that this is not textured yet. Huh. Whatever, it's fine. Alrighty, now I'll show you a nice comparison. This is how big the shaft used to be. Like, this was the size. It was a 3x3. This is how big it used to be, and this is how big it is now. Look at that. Doesn't that look much grander as you're going down? You're like, where are we going? Nobody knows, because it's scary. Anyways, that's that. I think it looks so much cooler. It definitely adds to the effect of, holy crap, this base is underground, and it could be miles before we get to it. Alrighty, so like I said, we could make the elevator a little bit larger if we wanted to. I think this actually looks... Oh, wait, we need to even that out eventually. But I think this looks nicer without the ladder here, so we might keep it like that so that it's not there. Now, let's find out where we want to put the blocks for this. If I put it there, that's too close. But if I put it... What if I put it here? Where will that go? Is that going to be in the wall already, or is that... Oh, that's still on the outside of the wall, so we could do that. If I go up a little further, is it still... We ran out of steel plates. No, I think that might be fine if we make the edge, like, right over there. So we'll have 2-block clearance on either side, and then we'll have the stuff going up. Yeah, that'll look pretty nice. Okay, well, let's get to work on that. Okay, so let's get the other side up, just so we know where it is as a nice visual aid. And we still have a little bit of room here, so technically... We could possibly... Let me go up a little bit more. Let me see if we still have that room as we go up. It looks like we do. So we could technically go out one more and we'd still be fine. Let's do that so we have a little bit more space. Do we have that same room on this one? I think we do. Yeah, we do. Okay, so let's do the same thing here. And a lot of these blocks are going to go away. It's just like when you're drawing, you sketch first sometimes so you know kind of what you're going to do. That's exactly what we're doing here. We're sketching first. All right, so that gives us a pretty good guide there for how we want to do this. I want to make it kind of follow the curve of that. So let's get our guide on this side as well. We had 3, right? 1, 2, 3, and then block. So let's go up on this side. See if we can get through. Yep. There's this one little lip down here that just didn't get any of the drill treatment. So we have to try and get past that every time we make a new block going up. Okay, so we have that. And then we have 1, 2, 3. So that would actually be the building itself. We could possibly do this. Ooh, that one's a little bit... Okay, the lip's a little larger here. Just have to break through it. Like I said, eventually we'll come through with the mini miner and even that out a little bit, but there we go. I guess where better a place to start than at the actual base of it. So this block is going to be the first one that stays. All those blocks are going to be removed, and it's going to connect right here to that. So these blocks right here can be removed, so it doesn't obstruct the walkway or anything. And this is going to just continue this way as the starting one to that one. That's going to be there, and then this one, same thing, is going to connect to that. Let's remove some block here. Give us some room to build. Five, and we'll just connect it this way. Whoops, I just broke something. Yeah. Little placeholder block. Awesome. Okay, now we've got our nice little frame going on here. This is actually starting to look pretty good. So we're gonna start right here with the actual frame of this, and then we're just gonna go up. Once we have the design built out here, we're just gonna go up from there, and it should eventually look nice, hopefully. So how do we want to do this, actually? So you know what, I'm gonna have a couple different levels and we'll do a couple different ideas, and then I'll come back and show you them, and we'll see which one you guys, or we'll see which one looks better. All right, we've got four designs right here that I want to show off, and we'll see which one looks the best. I haven't actually looked at them all yet. I've just built them, and I want to take a nice look. So this one right here is the kind of the obvious circle design right here. So it's just pretty much, it goes in a nice circle following the ridges of the thing right here. And that would look pretty nice, I think. It would just be a giant circle all around the thing. Moving on, we've got kind of a... It's not exactly a circle, but it's kind of... It provides more room for these. So we have another support on this side going up. So this one would have three instead of just one if we went with this design. However, it would look kind of like a 12-sided shape. So... I don't know. Also, we probably have to do a little bit more mining because I'm not sure that that would actually fit inside what we have right now, but we could easily do that. Just a little bit of mining up the sides here. The next design is just kind of a straight over, a straight cutover design, kind of. And I'm not really a fan of this one, probably. I don't know. It clears out a lot of the room that we could have that this one and the other one have. And the other one is kind of a weird design. It would make it look, I don't know, odd, not normal. It would just be just kind of weird. So I actually don't know which design I want to go with here. I think I'm going to cut this one out because I don't really like it. It just, it cuts off too much of the room. This one, I don't know. It would be nice having a three area because we could put windows that are 3x3s every once in a while. That would be pretty nice. This one right here also is pretty nice. It'd make it look a lot like a circle. The whole thing would look like a giant circle, like a silo going up. Whereas this one would look more like just a weird shape. And then, of course, we have the weird option. I guess the plus side with the weird option is we could stick lights pretty much everywhere because these are all straight blocks here we could put lights on, whereas these ones would be not as easy to throw. I fell down the thing. You know what? We're going to go boring. We're going to go boring with this one right here. We're just going to go straight up with this. And yeah. Which of these was your favorite? Which of the four? Did you like the weird design? Did you like the cut across design or the larger centerpiece design or the boring one that I chose? This one right here. I just think the boring one's gonna look the best once it's done, so let's make it boring. Okay, this is gonna require a lot of steel plates. Alright, well, the easiest way to do this is just gonna be grabbing the block and probably orienting the right way. This is the hardest part. There we go. And then just going straight up the whole way will probably be the easy. This is probably just gonna be the easiest way to go through this. So that's my life for the next probably, I don't know, probably 20 minutes. So let's do this. Okay, so all the blocks are in. That took, probably like 20 minutes, like I said it would. So how are we gonna weld it though, is the question. We could either A, I've got two ideas. I've got three ideas. We could A, grab our welding ship and do it with that, which might not be a bad idea. We could B, weld it ourselves, which probably is a bad idea, but it wouldn't take that long, maybe. Or we could do the same thing we did last time with the drilling and stick welders on this thing and then just drive it up as they weld. And that right there might not be a bad idea. So here we go. Oh, there we go. Looks like some of them aren't getting welded, those corner ones, but we should be able to do those manually. It's at least going to be way easier than doing all of them manually. So that should be fine. Are we going to get them all in one fell swoop? Well, all except for those corner ones. How are you not getting that one right there? The center one. It feels like that should be one of the ones you are getting. Because they're it's so close, but I don't know. It's getting the majority. Well, okay, there we go. We now have 12 welders, and they should hopefully get everything. Oh my god, listen to the sound of that. Just everything powering on at once. Okay, here we go. Hopefully this doesn't bang. Okay, yeah, actually this is working really well. There we go. This is actually kind of nice. Oh shoot, are we running? Oh no, oh no, oh no. I think we ran out of steel plates. Well, that's a rip. Hey, but this looks kind of cool. Gotta say, this the part that's welded at least. It looks really... Oh, what happened there? And there. Oh, you're slacking. You're slacking, dude. What's going on? And I said, hey, yeah, 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 yeah. Hey, yeah, yeah. I said, hey. What's going on? Ooh, what happened here? What's going on? Walking on the pipe. Okay, you know what? Since I don't want this whole episode to be about this elevator thing, so while we're waiting for this elevator to work, we're going to go, or to while we're waiting for the steel plates to make, we're going to go and increase our production efficiency by creating ourselves another assembler. And to do so, what does an assembler need? Wait, didn't they add a new build thing? Is that... They add like a new build thing. I don't know how to use it. But I feel like it's a button. I feel like there's a button that I press for that to be a thing. Add components from build planner to production queue. Ooh. So if I... Oh, okay. So add selected component to production queue. Okay. What'd I do? Did I... I'm not sure what I did just now. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna have to do more messing... Oh, that just gave it to me. I was like, what'd I do? I'm gonna have to do more messing around with this because they added this whole new system and I don't know how to use it and it makes me sad. Wait, can I... What did that do? Production. 5,800. And if I add, what does it do? 5,800 still. And if I add more, what does it do? I don't think that that's doing anything. Okay, well, you know what? I don't know exactly what we need, but I think we're going to need some of... Well, not that many of those. But some of these things for an assembler. Probably a lot of this. Maybe even a little bit of these. Okay, I can't add any more. Maybe some of these. Let's go see if we can build ourselves an assembler. I just don't remember exactly what it requires. But this room should be pressurized, actually. Let's see. Give that a few seconds. Hop in here. Well, I guess I turned off pressurization. Whatever. We need some displays and computers for that. We need some just computers for that. And we need some displays and computers for that. So we can get three more up and running as we speak. How awesome would that be? Well, we have to build these up, but... Displays, computers, and motors is all we need to get all three of those working. You should be not like that. Alright, we're back with what should be the last required things. Let's throw those in there. Throw those in there and throw those... Did we not bring enough computers? Are you serious? Well, at least we can get these up and running. Okay, so now we should have, instead of one assembler, we should now have three assemblers. So this one right here, let me go to production, actually. And I want to make sure, what is this one called right here? You are assembler 4. We're going to call you assembler king. You're the king assembler. And then every other one is going to be the not king one. So the king, this guy, is that one. Now everyone else, including number 5, is going to be in cooperative mode. And number 6 is also going to be in cooperative mode. So,
You guys working?
Yeah, okay, so we should now be producing at a faster rate than we were before. And that's cause for celebration, which we will celebrate by completing the elevator. Or the elevator shaft, at least. I think it's kind of funny how some words or some names of things do exactly what they're called. Like, for instance, the refrigerator. Refrigerates. It does, that's what it does. An elevator elevates. That's what it does. But a door, what does a door do? It doesn't door. It opens and closes. So why didn't we call it like an opener or like a closer? I don't know. Random questions with Andrew. You think about it, a container, it contains things. A conveyor, it conveys. It conveys something from point A to point B. But a pipe? What does it do? I mean, I guess pipe is an adjective, isn't it? Or a verb, to pipe something. I don't know. Like, a refinery refines stuff, an assembler assembles stuff, a sorter sorts stuff, a thruster thrusts, a gyroscope gyrates. But what does a battery do? It doesn't batter. And what does a seat do? It doesn't sat. I mean, you can sit in it, but I don't know. It's weird. Connectors connect. It's just some words are made after what they do, but other words just seem like random. I don't know, maybe you guys know more about words than I do, and you guys know the origins of like certain words like battery that don't seem to do anything. Or a cockpit. Why is it called that? I mean, I could venture a couple of guesses, but they're not PG. Alrighty, with this much, I think we should be good to go all the way to the top. Let's get in our seat, and I think we're ready to go. So turn these babies on, and let's continue. Okay, so it's gonna weld over all the stuff it missed, which is good. And there we go, it's continuing. We're gonna have to have one more pass, so we're gonna have to go down with these things turned on as well. So we get all the stragglers. This is pretty cool. Look at this, everyone working together to get this thing built. Oh, here we are, almost at the top. Can we not get past? Okay, we're stuck on something. I think it's probably the, there's a station right here that I think we're stuck on. There. Ah, the pipe! The pipe that is weird. No, come back! And that, by the way, is why I wanted to manually press this thing. How come you're not getting that guy? Right there. Are we out of? Okay, I think we ran out just at the end. Whoa, that's going really fast. Oh god, I think I, oh no, okay. There we go. I think I sped it way up, which is super dangerous. All right, there we go. That's going to be our thing. Let's hop out of this. We'll sit on it for an awesome ride down. But I think that looks pretty cool. It looks much much more scary and ominous and stuff. And that's exactly what I'm going for. All right, let me do one last pass so I can add some windows right here and I can add some lights on the side, and then we'll call it an episode. All right, it's finally done. People, behold the shaft. Probably not a good choice of words. The elevator shaft. The very PG elevator shaft. Look how bright it is. It's got all these lights. I decided to not do the windows. I just thought it looked a little weird. I tried it with one or two of them and it looked a little bit odd. So, you know what? I kind of just like this. I'm going to do something about the top up there because it still looks a little weird. But for now, this is... Oh my god! Stop! Jesus! What was that? The speed was on point two. Why? I don't understand. Hang on. Buttons. Elevator. What the heck just happened? Ah, the speed was on two. That was my fault. Nope. Please. Okay. Oh my god. All right. We're back. Don't know what happened to that guy, but let's change the speed. Elevator. Okay. So what is it? Is it control click or control right click maybe? Control right click? No. Shift click. No, it's control click. Okay, control click. So we need negative 0.2 and not negative 2, which is what I had it set on. Okay, so now I should be able to reverse. Look at that. That's funny. Okay, now we should be able to go up at a nice speed. Okay, look at this. It's kind of dangerous because you can fall off, but oh my god! But it looks super cool. Actually, oh my god, that right there looks super cool in my opinion. That is awesome. And we're, you know, you kind of slowly go up to the top. There's a stop right here that will eventually have like an actual like ledge going out that you can stop at. But for now, you know, it's just normal. Oh, it's so dark up here because it's nighttime. Oh, that makes sense. Okay, so for now, what you have to do is you have to kind of judge it and then stop it right there and make a jump. You cannot make that jump. That's not possible. Wow. One more try. Oh, it's almost possible. Not quite possible. Perhaps if we were a little higher, like up here, maybe you can make it. Okay, you can make it there, but can you make it back? Oh, just shy. But anyway, yeah, that's how that goes. And then can it go all the way to the top? I think probably. And... Oh, no! Ah! I forgot, since it can actually get through the hole, it doesn't stop now. So we need to make it go up a little more. Okay. A little more. Yeah! Okay, there we are! Perfectly in one piece. At the top, we can see our nice windmills and a nice silhouette over there. Okay, yeah, that's a good place to end it. Let's hop outside, see what's out here. Ooh! Earth. The final frontier, I guess. Alright, well that is that episode where we built the nice, awesome elevator shaft and we did some other modifications to the elevator. Oh, that looks cool! You can almost fall through right here. I might have to use voxel editor to try and like clear this up, or I'll have to find some way to get around that with blocks. But yeah. Anyways, if you guys liked that episode, please hit the like button, put your comments and your suggestions down below in the comments section, and I will see you guys in the next episode of Space Engineers. Ah!